Good afternoon. So my name is Siddharth. I am the founder at Pinut. I think these lights are quite okay. So what is Pinut? Pinut is an offline content distribution platform. It's a heavy word. I think I'll explain the tagline, what exactly it's to. So I'll just take you with the first word, which is offline. So why offline? Why offline? Because as Lalitesh, in fact, in the morning speech, he told that we have to cater to that 1 billion people who are sitting outside the gate. So why offline? Because those people are not connected. Not only in India, but across the globe, there are people, there are locations which are not even connected. They don't even know what exactly your Khan Academy is or what exactly Wikipedia is. They don't have any sources of learning from these places. So, they are not connected. In fact, in India itself, only 9% of the rural India is connected. So does that mean, so going forward, we assume that, okay, there'll be connectivity at those places as well, but can they afford it? Will they be able to watch a YouTube video with a very minimal price? Will they be able to afford that pricing? I don't think so, in the near future at least. And going back, say, suppose even if they are able to afford those pricing, are they educated enough to filter out the very relevant content to themselves, which is very useful to them? If you open the world of internet to those people who are not educated enough to filter out the content, they'll go on the other side of the internet rather than going to the relevant part of it. So, like, how do we solve this problem? How do we provide them the very relevant content to these people who are outside this gate in a very curated form? So how do we do that? How do we bridge this gap of information and education between the rural and the urban places? How do we do that? So here we come up with a solution called Pinut. So it's a very basic small step, you can say, to bridge that gap of information and education between the rural and the urban places. This is a box which is a Wi-Fi router plus a media streaming server and an analytics engine running on top of it. So what does it do? So we closely work with NGOs and government bodies. What these people do is that they put the relevant content to that community inside this box. So relevant content like your Wikipedia in an offline mode in their own local languages. Your Khan Academy, a lighter version of it in their own local languages. Your class 1 to 12 lessons, vocational trainings for them, fishing and farming videos for them so that they can grow organically or any other things which are coming up to them. Any policies government has pushed to these rural places, any surveys to be filled out, any feedback forms to be taken care of. All these things are plugged into this thing as a form of content. And then it's shown in the, so the, basically it's placed in the community centers in rural part of India, basically in, you can say, panchayat houses, post office, or open schools, where people with their very basic Wi-Fi enabled devices, they come, connect to these boxes, and then stream, download the data, give exams, assessments, certifications, totally in offline mode. They need not to have internet onto it. So, or to access that content for it. So they can browse those HD videos as well, which is very relevant to them, from which they can learn and give exams as well. So all of this is happening in a offline mode. Basically, this box works as a local cloud for them, a local server for them to at least take care of their educational and informational needs. As Lalitesh told us about the information systems we have to build. So basically, this becomes a very small information system in that local area, which these people can access in their own local languages. So how does the interaction happens? They just have to, so I'll just show you. So yeah, they just have to download the app, which is also sitting in this box. For downloading the app, they need not to go to internet. So once they connect to the Wi-Fi, which this guy is publishing, it opens a captive portal. They download the app through that captive portal and then run. So it works out. They educate themselves, they learn themselves. And not only this, so. So yeah, once it's connected to internet, you can just put your dongle to it or any other place you can put dongle to this thing, and it'll be connected to internet. Once it's connected to internet, all the data which people have accessed, like they have watched what
one
all
more
videos.
Minute remaining.
Yeah, they have watched what all videos. If they have given any exams, what are the exams results? And everything is pushed to the cloud, and you can see that the NGOs or government bodies sitting at their own places can check it out what exactly people are doing with these boxes. So how they are educating, if they have filled any forms or any government surveys which has to be filled, what are the results for these things? You need not to go and knock every door in the village to get these forms or surveys filled out. So you just push it into it, and then you are done. And these, once connected to internet, all these boxes can be accessed through cloud. So you can change the data, you can have any type of refreshment from the cloud itself. And yeah, the dashboard looks like who all watch what all things, what are the popular videos watch, what are the details of the people who watched it. Yeah. So what are the other verticals we are working on?
Sorry, but the time's out. Can we give Siddharth a big round of applause?